Well, we've looked at symbolism in the Truman Show. I mean, you can see it right here. Here's the Masonic honeybee. Check my previous videos for that. But I wanted to dig into other movies from the guy who wrote the Truman Show, Andrew Niccol. So I went over to, of course, IMDb to take a look at all of the movies he's been involved with. And the Truman Show came out in 1998. Before that was Gattaca. And right after the Truman Show was Simone. So I figured, what better one to start with Simone? And this movie is about Al Pacino creating a actress who is completely digital. She doesn't exist. She's just a CG actor. But everybody thinks she's real. And there's some funny symbolism and signs. Let's look at the top five.
Mr. Taransky? Mr. Taransky, thank God I've been trying to see you.
Back off.
I haven't. Mr. Taransky, the answer to your prayers.
I don't know where you come from.
It's me! Mr. Taransky, don't you recognize me? The Future of Film Conference in San Jose. Remember that? Hank Helino. I was the keynote speaker there. You must remember my speech. Who needs humans?
Right. Right, you were booed off the stage. I remember. Whoa, that's gotta be...
8 years ago.
Whoa.
And that whole time, I never left my computer.
You're talking about a synthespian, a virtual actor.
No, we call them Vactors. Vactors. With my new computer code, it can be done. You have something that I don't have.
What's that?
An eye. You know the truth when you see it. I know. I've seen your movies. I have seen every frame of your work. I mean, you're the only filmmaker with the artistic integrity.
I'll call you about this next week. We can call.
I won't be here in a week. The tumor's inoperable.
I'll call you about it, okay?
No, but listen, that's what I'm trying to say. The tumor is inoperable. I'll be dead. Call me! This week! Please.
Did you see it? A left eye passed by in the background, and let's zoom in on it. This isn't a regular eye. This is a reptilian eye. And that's pretty funny because Simone is not a movie about reptilians or any aliens or anything like that. It's only about this digital actress. And for some reason, we get this guy who only has a left eye. His right eye is gone, and at the end of the scene, for some reason in the background, a left reptilian eye scrolls past at the end of the hallway. Now, one funny thing about the actor who plays this guy with the left eye. His name is Elias Koteas, but he does not appear in the credits. Although he played a pretty big role right here in the beginning of the movie, you'll notice that his name is not in the credits at all. There is no Elias Koteas. However, towards the very end of the credits, it does say, Simone wishes to thank the following for their contribution to the making of Simone. And at the bottom of the list, it says Hank Helino Software Incorporated. Number two, a reference to NASA research.
Our ability to manufacture fraud now exceeds our ability to detect it.
I'm going to tell the truth about you. Why wouldn't I? Of course, with Hank's tragic passing, his secret did die with him.
Here it shows the newspaper of the obituary for just a moment. And now we see a reference to Freemasonry, where Hank Helino is 33 years old and found dead at his computer. He was a computer software designer who was responsible for creating the radical regulated refrigeration known as RRR. And over on the right side, and over here, those years developing RRR for the Weiske company. There are a great many speculations as to what his last computer endeavors had been. Some believed he was involved with NASA developing software to communicate with possible life forms on Mars, while others conjecture his interests were in the V-something realm. In any event, he had not been seen in over 8 years and had not been interacting with fellow software engineers. So now we get another secret message here that some type of connection between what appears to be reptilian humanoids with a reptilian eye, left eye symbolism, and NASA trying to communicate with life forms on Mars or some other type of realm. Now, all this seems a little bit too much of a coincidence to just be some kind of science fiction. When I read the book from Emanuel Swedenborg, which was written in the 1700s, called Concerning the Earths in Our Solar System, which are called planets, and Concerning the Earths in the Starry Heaven. Let's turn to page 91, Concerning the Earth or Planet Mars, Its Spirits and Inhabitants. The spirits of Mars are amongst the best of all spirits who come from the Earths of this solar system, being for the most part celestial men not unlike those who were of the most ancient church of this earth. Spirits then came to me and applied themselves to my left temple, where they breathed upon me their discourse, but I did not understand it. And they breathed upon my left temple and the up and left ear, and proceeded then down to the left eye. And here where he's talking about the planet Mercury, page 17, at another time I saw a multitude of such spirits some distance from me, a little bit to the right, and they discoursed with me, but by means of intermediate spirits, for their speech was quick as thought, which does not fall into human speech, but by means of other spirits. And what surprised me, they spoke not singularly, but together, readily and rapidly. Their speech appeared undulatory, who spoke at the same time. And what is remarkable, it conveyed towards my left eye, although they were to the right. The reason was because the left eye corresponds to the knowledges of things abstracted from what is material, consequently to such things which appertain to intelligence, whereas the right eye corresponds to such things which appertain to wisdom. So in this book from the 1700s, we have left eye symbolism, communicating with spirits on the other planets, including Mars, Mercury, and in Simon, we have the left eye symbolism with a left reptilian eye, and a text that says that NASA is developing software to communicate with beings on Mars and some type of V realm. Number three is nothing too special, but it is the 666 hand symbol from Simone, and it's such a perfect 666 hand symbol. I just had to include it in this video.
Give me Audrey.
How do I look?
Perfect. Perfect, Simone.
Moving on to number four.
And welcome. Simone, the question on everybody's mind is simply, why?
Frank, you know as well as I do, living in this fishbowl, the insatiable appetite of the media.
Living in this fishbowl. Now, what does that remind you of? Operation Fishbowl with Richard Byrd? And a fishbowl isn't a very good match for Sphere Earth, but it certainly is a pretty good match for the Flat Earth Theory with the dome firmament, like we see in The Simpsons when the fishbowl got a crack in the top and a water leaked in. So pretty funny that Simone uses the word fishbowl to describe the Earth, and right before she says fishbowl, of course, we have the Sphere Earth right here on the screen.
Simone, the question on everybody's mind is simply, why?
Frank, you know as well as I do, living in this fishbowl.
And finally, number five, with a fair warning for a spoiler alert. If you're planning to watch this movie, stop now, as this is the final conclusion of the movie. But let's see what happens with this digital actress who isn't even real, but everyone believes she's real, Everyone thinks she's a real movie actor, and they idolize her, and they want to go see her movies and see her concerts. Let's see what's in store for this digital actress's future career.
But now I understand you're eager to get back to work, and it's not the kind of work we were all expecting.
It's true. I can reveal I am considering a career in politics.
And what, may I ask, brought this on?
I suppose this little man had something to do with it.
That beautiful baby.
Yes. You see, Victor and I are both very concerned about what kind of world our new son Chip is going to grow up in. Aren't you, Victor?
Oh, yes.